Let's jump into our C1, 2, 3, and 4. Now C1 is going to be very simple. It's my autofocus manual focus toggle. Now I know a lot of people put their focus mode in their function menu, but this is not good enough. You have to be able to switch between auto and manual quickly, and something I often do. And there's going to be moments where your autofocus is jumpy because it's too dark or it's too light. Manual focus just lets you dial it in and it's quickly right there, C1. C1 and C2 are my two most often used settings. So it's going to be my auto and manual focus, and then C2 is going to be my white balance. It's not good to have your white balance on auto, because within the same room or in the same scene, if your subject is moving, your white balance will shift. It's something that the camera will do automatically. And what happens is when you try to color correct or when you try to color grade, you'll have shifting colors. You'll have shifting warmth inside of the same video, which is a no-no for me. It makes it very difficult to edit. So being able to choose my white balance right off the bat when I'm going from room to room or from scene to scene, having that at C2, because it's going to be often used, is very beneficial for me. Now C3 is going to be my APS-C toggle. The APS-C crop I think is 1.5, so you can take a 50mm and go to 75mm with just a click of a button. C3 is my metering mode. Now metering, if you don't understand this yet, you'll have to do a little more research, but my metering mode will switch between highlight, multi, or entire screen average sometimes. But I prefer, when I'm shooting video, I really prefer doing highlight metering, and if I'm doing photography, I'll do multi-metering. This setting is only utilized if you have your ISO set to auto. The camera will set your exposure for you. This is beneficial for me because I find that the Sony cameras do a really good job of exposure metering.